Showing solidarity tonight with victims of the Mumbai massacre. 174 people, including six Americans, died in those attacks. Among them, a New York rabbi and his wife, who had strong ties to L.A. CBS 2's Dave Meekum takes us to a memorial in Westwood.
And it's sad for everybody, especially the Chabad people. They're the most unbelievable, welcoming, and wonderful people.
The backdrop was the world's very first Chabad house. There are now thousands serving the Jewish community around the world. It is where Rabbi Gavriel Holzberg and his wife worked.
The last I saw of him was he was leaving the synagogues every morning to go back to his house.
UCLA's Dr. Sherwin Eisenberg just missed what has now been called India's 9/11. And how ironic, he says, Rabbi Holzberg's sermon days before, all about kindness to animals.
And then 4 days later, human animals come and massacre him.
In all, 174 dead, six of them Americans, over 200 others injured. Just who's responsible, still not clear.
We tend to focus on the name of the terrorist. What's the name? He's 24 years old, and he went into Chabad house and murdered a young rabbi and his wife. But he was sent to murder them by so-called religious leaders, and it's about time that those religious leaders faced up to the consequences of the havoc that they have caused.
He was a good man. He was a tremendous scholar. He knew how to learn. He always had a smile on his face.
And they'd gone to school together back in Brooklyn, all of it pieces of this memorial, including a sheriff who identifies as a Christian, saying all religions must come together.
God does not reward murderers.
And one other piece, the couple's 2-year-old boy is doing well. Somehow, some way, a nanny was able to get him out. In Westwood, Dave Meekum, CBS 2 News.